New video shows Freddie Gray minutes after his initial arrest, the last time he was seen publicly and alive. The video is short, but it shows Gray not moving, lying half in, half out of the police van.
Numb them. Numb them with crack cocaine, reality TV, Mary Jane, so that all they know is pain, but they can't feel it. I felt it in my spirit when those riots broke loose. It was like that tree was too weak for that body and that noose. Like the whips on the back of a body from the roots. Only God could heal these lashes, but instead they sent in troops. Because the work ain't honest, but it pays the bills. Y'all know they just signed a bill for like 30 mil to put a U jail in my city, right? Now I'm looking at my city like all that paper for a motherfucking pen. But that's why we write, right? To shed light on broken promises and reflect on shattered dreams. No child left behind or no child unconfined. They gonna either trap them in a cell or trap them in their mind. Too much Jeezy on repeat. Too much Jeezy on repeat. And I bump Jeezy all the time when really, Willie Lynch, the real trap of the year for like 400 years, in fact. But we still flip packs and serve them to Brenda. No, Brenda's got a baby. When Brenda barely got a brain, it's a damn shame because Brenda can barely spell a name. But they feed us stories about black on black crimes like it's scripture, my nigga. And they ain't teach us to read correctly, so I hope you get the picture, my nigga. I mean, the blacker the story, the more pages come up missing. We got brothers killing fathers and sons coming up missing. I'm missing you like crazy, but we treat it like it's no biggie where your faith at. We got rappers saving hoes, but where they cape at? When it's man down and the cops come round, when it's round for round, King lose his crown. I mean, I thank God for the Pox, the Kendrick Lamars, the Nina Simones that took that paper and that pen and made bars of their own and broke open a bar with every bar and let the secret be known that the mind can't be confined. You got a cell of your own. The mind can't be confined. You got a cell of your own. Your brain cell. You gotta be wise enough to know that what they selling is wrong. I said the mind can't be confined. You got a cell of your own. Because the work ain't honest, but it pays the bills. Someone please call 911. Tell them I've just been shot down. And the bullet's in my heart. And it's piercing through my soul. Feel my body getting cold. Thank you.
That's right, y'all call. Y'all call.
Y'all call.
Come on.
Who's back? Who's back? Who's back? Who's back? Who's back? Who's back? Who's back?
I've got tons of memories from there. In high school, tons of memories with growing up in an all-boys independent school. Having a fun, my first car, my first time going out alone. My brother and I ran out to get chapstick because we were so excited about finally getting our licenses.
What would you want people to say about
yeah,
you?
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't all unicorns and roses.
How would you feel if all you've ever been is a stereotype? If you are always being looked at by what other people say from you or by history, but not people are not looking deeper into what you actually are. Why judge by your skin color, your hair, your race, your sex? I am a firm believer that
teaching dance as a means to get young people to grow creatively and spiritually for their lives. I am celebrating 34 years of teaching, and I've made it my goal to make sure that not only am I teaching them dance, but through teaching of dance, I'm also teaching them how to be a decent human being as far as their home life, their community, their church life, as well as dancing. But my goal ultimately is to help them to succeed in whatever area they decide that they want to go into. But I use dance as a means to discipline them and to get them on a path where they will have discipline, integrity, creativity, as well as the kind of life that is conducive to them being successful.
Really have their evolution from the old patrols during the slave trade. And so people during the slave, during slavery. And so people are often shocked by people. And I'm not shocked. I mean, I think that America has began as a violent nation, began as a nation that enslaved people, both for racist reasons and for economic reasons. In other words, they just use black people. And so they then created laws, a police system, and the rest to justify and legitimize what they were doing.
Have been doing, and you allow them to do because you voted them in there? Are you that angry with me? Come on now. Go ahead and sit down somewhere. And that was my attitude. I was not a happy camper because you're lashing out at me. And I'm not talking about the kids. Kids are doing it because they can. I'm talking about the adults. The adults that were out there that were acting like they were children, that were not bringing their kids in to say, hey, listen, no, all those officers didn't do that. Everybody that's out there didn't do that. That's not how this works. Come on, let me tell you something. No, they were out there with them.
Being a police officer, the toughest part about being a police officer was just making sure that other officers saw people the way I saw people, meaning respecting everyone, treating everyone as people and not as something less than that, making sure that the people that we serve also saw us as people. Saw police as people.
I don't necessarily support riots. I understand why riots happen. But what I do support is building strong networks in the community. I believe in building strong formations in the community to protect the community and to help the community grow. And toward that end, along with a coalition of friends, we are engaged right now in building a community youth center, Tubman House, right in the Gilmore Hall.